The next planet I'm going to cover is Mercury. Now, normally with Vedic astrology, we like to have the planets in a certain order, Sun, Moon, Mars. That's the order of the day of the week, and that's the order that the planets take their turn in running the planet. So on Monday, the Moon runs the planet. On Tuesday, Mars rules the planet, and or runs the planet, let's say. But we're going to follow a different order, and the order we're going to follow in this course is we started at the Sun sign Leo, so we went with Sun, then we went to Moon Cancer. Now we're going to Gemini and Virgo, or Mercury, their Lord. So we're going to be moving in this order based on the zodiac, where we'll be going from Mercury to Venus to Mars to Jupiter and lastly to Saturn. Okay? Whatever order you take, you're always starting with Sun and ending at Saturn. And well, the reason I'm taking this order because the planets have somewhat of a pairing going on. Alright? The Sun, no. The Sun is just himself. He's like, this is who I am, and I'm stuck in what I am, and I can't be anything else but that. Okay? And it is not compromising. It doesn't work in pairs. It's going to do its own thing. It doesn't need the help of anybody. Okay? Then as we talked about, the Moon comes along and is like, well, the world doesn't work that way. There's not a perfect hole for your square little self to fit into. And so the Moon allows us to adapt and work as ourselves in a world where we don't completely fit. Okay? And Moon has a sun called Mercury, and Mercury supports the Moon in that activity. Okay? So the Moon is here to adapt. And one important thing I forgot to mention is that, you know, the king, the sun, has his kingdom, which is Leo, right? Well, the Moon, which is the queen, doesn't have a kingdom. She has Cancer, which rules foreign places. It's everything that's not your home. Actually, Cancer, people like say that's your home. Well, no, in Vedic astrology, Cancer is foreign places, foreign things. It's the things that we adapt to. It's the things that aren't us that we adapt to. That's what Cancer is. That's why it's a changeable, movable sign. It can change, it can adapt. Okay? So, Mercury, so the Moon is adapting to what's always foreign. Okay? And the Moon actually, Mercury as the sun of the Moon, actually helps the Moon in that job. Okay, so the next step in our process after the Moon, after the fact that, hey, the world, we don't fit in this world, we have to adapt to it and make the most of it through the Moon. Then Mercury comes along and says, I'll help you, all right? I'll help you, Mom, right? Because Mercury, very importantly, is the prince, the princess. Now, we have all these great stories about how wonderful it is to be the crown prince, the princess, the heir to the throne. But the reality of it, it's not that wonderful, because what that's saying is, Daddy knows his shit, Mommy knows his shit, and you don't. You just have to go figure it out. So, a prince had to jump through these loopholes, he had to learn things, he had to learn how to rule the kingdom. Okay, he had to learn how to be a useful force in the kingdom. Sure, he was born, he was entitled, but he wasn't going to get the throne if he was incapable. So, one of the things the parents did, as a rule, they would have the son go do things. Go talk to this country and work on this treaty. And the son's like, really, me? And you're like, yeah, go. So this kid goes out there who really doesn't know what he's doing. And he goes out there. You know, he just, you know, goes out there with faith that, gosh, I don't know how I'm going to do this, but my parents said I need to, so I'll do it. And the parents send him on these, you know, missions, give him these important tasks, because they know he needs to be prepared so that when they die, he's like got the experience, got enough experience that the kingdom doesn't succumb to disaster. So as the crown prince, Mercury is always the planet that says, geez, I really don't know, but I'll go for it. I'll try to figure it out. Okay, I'll try to figure out how to write a treaty when I get there. Because the reality of life, we can't be prepared for anything until we've done it. We're fully prepared once we've done it. Okay? We're not fully prepared until that point. It doesn't matter how much education you have, how much you've learned about something. You're not prepared until you've done it correctly once, right? So Mercury's this planet that spends most of his time running around trying to figure out how to do something right the first time. Okay? Mercury, the intelligence of Mercury is mamamsa, which means the investigative intelligence. It's the ability to investigate something and figure it out. So you do your thing, you investigate it, you figure it out, and then you can start doing it. That's what Mercury is ultimately all about. On a philosophical level, the mamamsa philosophy is about a process of investigating life until you arrive at the conclusion that, well, God is what exists. Like physicists, they're investigating matter. They investigated the atom. They broke the atom. They're investigating electrons, protons. They're investigating beyond those things. And their conclusion is, wow, there's something here that's not here. Okay? They've investigated to the point that they're starting to understand the truth in a better way, in a bigger way. We're not just atoms like we thought we were 400 years ago. So this process of investigation is so critical to Mercury. So Mercury is like, yeah, I'll go check it out. That's Mercury. So the question is, are you in the habit of checking things out and trying things that need to be checked out and tried? That's all Mercury is. Okay, that's all a good habit Mercury is. That's the foundation of a good habit Mercury, is that it's in the habit of trying things to see what happens. Okay, to investigate things and see where it leads. This is such an important thing. It's through investigation that we get to anything solid. Okay, it's like Sherlock Holmes, okay? He's the great investigator, right? I like to use him as my Mercury example. He gets a list of suspects, and he investigates a suspect, and he writes the suspect off his list. It's not you. And he writes the suspect off the list. It's not you. And it's not you. And eventually, there's only one suspect left. And so it has to be that person, right? And if not, then there's an undisclosed suspect that they have to continue looking for, even the suspect. But by trying things and recognizing it's not that, it's not that, it's not that, you get closer to what you're really looking for. It's kind of like dating, right? The difference between people with good and bad Mercury is when they try to date. Of course, lots of other planets come into play too, but I'm just focusing on the Mercury part. A good Mercury will investigate people. They'll see what people are like. A bad Mercury, you know, meet someone, there's an attraction, and they decide, oh, I'm in love, this is forever. No investigation took place. You know, it's just taking a shot in the dark. You know, and then they go to the astrologer and they're told there's some compatibilities and they use that information. Or if they have a badly starved Mercury by the moon, they'll be told by the astrologer that, no, this person's not right for you, and they will tell themselves that it's right and do it anyway. They're not investigating healthily. Yes, taking a chart to the astrologer is a healthy way to investigate a partner, a job, a residence, anything. You know, that's a method of investigation, is Mercury, is astrology. But really, we should investigate everything. All right? What does that do for us? It gives us two things. It gives us a chance to recognize our ability to make correct choices. You know, because when you investigate something, your inner voice already told you yes or no most of the time. The minute you saw that thing, if you should go for it or not. But you haven't heard it, because you're not the king, you're the heir apparent, right? You want to be the son, but it's going to be a long time before you're the son and really stable in living your truth. Until then, you have to go through all these other planets, okay? One of which is Mercury, which means you have to investigate things and then go, wait a minute, that didn't work. And you know, the feeling I had, that feeling I had inside of myself, when I started this, was, this isn't going to work. Oh yeah, I recognize that feeling. I know what it feels like. Next time, I'll pay more attention to it. And this inner voice I'm talking about, it sounds so nice, doesn't it? But I really can't emphasize how smart this inner quality is. See, your brain can only measure the known factors. Your brain can say, he makes a lot of money, he's in good shape, He wants to have kids, you know. He's in his work field, he's the only one that even knows what he does. He's one of a kind. Wow, what a catch. Your brain says that, and you go marry the guy. But your inner voice is saying, don't marry the guy. But you marry the guy. 6 months later, you're pregnant, and he gets in a car accident, and he dies. And what he does, only he can do. There's no way you could even know how to manage his counseling business. And you're a poor single mom, the thing you didn't want to be, exactly what your mom was. Okay? But your inner voice knew he was going to die in 6 months. I mean, your inner voice knew that, no, if you commit to this, something's going to drastic happen. I mean, our inner voice knows things that our brains can't even dream up. And it doesn't tell us any of these things. It just says, go for it or don't go for it. Okay? Say yes to this or say no to this. You know, go like this or like this. It's a quick, simple thing. It doesn't explain itself. Okay? It's true wisdom. It's Jupiter, the true wisdom, who doesn't speak much. So part of learning to listen to that voice is to try and see what happens. Okay, I think I should do this. Is it my inner voice, or is it my conditioning? Is it my wounds? Is it my neediness? Is it my emptiness that's making me say I should do this? Let's find out. Okay? If after doing it, you feel good, you know, okay, that feeling was actually my inner voice talking to me. If after doing it, you feel frustrated, bitter, angry, totally lost, all right, that was your inner voice actually saying don't go for it, but you didn't hear it, you heard something else. So you're training to be the king. Mercury trains you to be the king, even in respect to your inner voice. But it trains you to build your kingdom in all things by just trying and seeing what happens. Okay? When Mercury is in a bad habit, people are in the habit of not trying to do something until they're convinced that it's going to work out. And these people, they're the ones who pay predictive astrologers the big bucks. What's going to happen if I do this? If I do this, what will happen? You know, tell me what's going to happen next year so I can figure out how to make it not happen. I mean, these people want sure things. And until they know there's a sure thing, they don't want to go for it. So the bad habit is, I'm not going to go for it until I know it's a sure thing. Which basically means you're never going to go for it. Because you go to the 10 best astrologers in the country and they all give you a different answer. You know? So, Mercury is the one that says, okay, I'm going to just try. It's not that big a deal to try. It's like Sherlock Holmes when he goes to number one suspect. He's just going to investigate and try and see if that person really did the murder. If that person doesn't do the murder, he just forgets about it, moves on to the next thing. That's a good Mercury. I'm just going to try this. I'm just going to go on a date with this person. I'm just going to try this job, see how it fits. I'm going to try to do this new project. I'm going to try to learn something new. And see if it's something I have an ability or skill for. And you try it, and it works or it doesn't work. In real life, so many things don't work. Most things don't actually work. You know? Most things are not compatible to who we are. And part of figuring that out is by trying them. Okay? So the prince is out there trying things. The princess is trying things. That's what it's all about. Okay? Now, one of the hard things about trying is that trying means the possibility of losing, right? If you try and you fail, someone else gets it. You try to get a job, you try to get a girl, you try to get a guy. If you don't get it, someone else is going to get it. And boy, can that hurt. Doesn't it suck when someone succeeds where you have failed? It does to a bad Mercury person, okay? But to a good Mercury, it doesn't. Because the good Mercury, his deity is Vishnu, okay? Now, deity is considered the super nice, great deity, all right? But becoming, you know, seeing the world as a Vishnu devotee, really practicing the ideology of Vishnu, is a really hard thing for humans to do, because it's the idea that everything is a manifestation of God. You're a manifestation of God, he's a manifestation of God, I'm a manifestation of God, the girl's a manifestation of God, and all three of us want her. And only one's going to get her. The good Mercury is like, well, only one guy gets her. If it's her, him, or her, what's the if it's me or him, what's the difference? Only one person is going to win the race. If it's me or him, what's the difference? God's winning the race. So it's this idea that whoever wins deserves it, because that's how the person God is experiencing the victory is as. That's the person God gets to experience himself as, that woman as. Okay? Or gets to experience himself as, that job as. It's all God experiencing God at the end of the day. And that gives a lightness to our way of being. Okay? It gives us the ability to lose. You know? Oh, God's only going to win, you know. Only one person, God can only win this race as one person at a time. What's the difference who it is? It's God winning it, right? Oh, and by the way, it's God losing it, and that's me today. Yeah, okay? That's the Vishnu attitude. But we have this heaviness to us that, I have to do this or else. Wow, then trying can be so painful, because most of the time, we're going to not win, okay? You know, most of the time we're just not going to, we're not going to win. It's not supposed to be. It's supposed to be a training ground. It's the prince trying to become mature to be able to rule the kingdom someday. Which means Mercury is the stage in us where we try things. So we develop our abilities. We develop knowledge about ourselves. We develop knowledge about the things and the people we want in our lives. And in so doing, we become more capable of running our kingdoms, okay, as the sun, as ourselves, all right? All right, now, the self aspect of Mercury is the consciousness spoken, okay? Now, the moon is the manas, it's your mind, it's everything in your mind. It's what you're imagining, it's what you're dreaming about. Okay, as well. It's what's in your, it is your everything in your consciousness. And then Mercury is the consciousness spoken. It's the part of your mind that pops out of your mouth. Okay? So like to teach astrology, I've spent a lot of time in my mind about astrology, right? And because of that, astrology pops out of my mouth. Okay? And if you hang out with me, I'll make card jokes and I'll make astrology jokes, because a lot of my mind is on that. I'm not going to tell you the other kind of jokes I tell though, because of other things in my mind, okay? I'm just going to keep the fun side up, right? But the things on our mind invariably come out through our speech. It's what's in our minds. And that's a good thing to think about, because, you know, we're here to find out who we are. And one of the ways is simply to watch what's coming out of our mouth. Oh, wow, I'm that. But wait a minute, I always point fingers at that when I see people like that. But that's the kind of stuff that is coming out of my mind, my mouth. So it must be in my mind somewhere. So a great way to get to know ourselves is to start listening to ourselves more and seeing what's in our mind. And then we can decide, is what's in my mind really what's most important to me? Or did it get stuck in my mind for some other reason? And then you figure out the reason. And oftentimes, a lot of the stuff stuck in our mind is in our minds because we're not living as ourselves. And so we're unhappy and we're frustrated, and our mind goes to all kinds of places and gets lost there. And then that comes out in the words that pop out of our mouth, the things we say, and the way we say it too. So watch what's in your mind. Now, as I mentioned, Mercury's all about trying things though. So to resolve the things that come out of your mouth, lots of times you just need to go try them and see what it even means to you. Because see, it's in your mind. But it's not going to do you any good there. Okay? We were born not in jars, with this mind in a jar of liquid where it lives forever. We were born with bodies that have senses attached to them. And so anything that impacts this body, or let's put it this way, our body has to have an impact for us to know something. Like there's this idea, you know, knowledge is not yours until your body knows it. You're a good astrologer when your body knows the astrology. It's like a kung fu master, right? Kung fu master, he learns it with his mind and he practices. He says, okay, this is the right way to do his techniques. He's not a kung fu master until his body does it all by itself, with his mind not even being present. So I'm a brag, okay? When I got ran over, you know, by the truck, I mean, Srishti got hit on her tandem bike 5 years ago now from behind. Someone came up in their pickup and smashed into us from behind. I heard this horrible crunch behind me and of him smashing into Srishti and smashing into the back of the bike. And I got launched at least 30 feet through the air. I just felt this force behind me like a cannon. And I'm like, I'm getting launched out of a cannon. I don't know if Srishti's even alive. All I know is I'm going to have to do a perfect roll to get out of this one, you know. And then I woke up 40 feet from the bike in the ditch with not a scratch on me from anything that wasn't the car hitting me. So yeah, I had a scratch here from the car breaking my ribs. I had a bruised hip from the car hitting me. My ankles were a little sore from my feet getting twisted in the pedals as I got launched off the front of the bike. But I somehow managed to roll 30 feet, fly through the air and roll 30 feet or so without a scratch, without impaling myself on some little tree sticking out of the ground, without scraping myself on the pavement. And I don't even know how I did it. I have no recollection of rolling. I just remember thinking, I'm getting launched out of a canyon and getting up on my knees 30 feet away, coming out of a roll and not being able to breathe because of two broken ribs. And my body knew how to roll. The roll was in my body. If I had needed to tell myself, okay, the way to roll is this, I would have gotten way more messed up because I would have not only got hit by the car, but I would have hit the ground. I would have been thrashed into the ground. But somehow my body just took over and it knew what it needed to do. Our body has its own ability for knowledge. So we understand that with cool shit like Kung Fu and stuff. But it's about everything. It's about your astrology. You can't make predictions well until your body knows the astrology. You can't do anything well. You can't know it until your body knows it. So the things that come out of your mouth are all bullshit. You know, the consciousness spoken is not real yet until you've had a bodily experience of it. And then you can find out if it's a reality for you, if it's you or not. Until then, it's just an idea that somehow got stuck in your head. It could be a good idea, could be a bad idea, could be a pathological idea. Most of the times, it's actually a bad idea. Because like I said, most of what Mercury's going to try is not us. You know, Mercury's life is full of failure. That's why he needs to be a Vishnu devotee. Oh, that's okay. I'm just God being God. You know, I'm just being a fool. Mercury needs to have that. Mercury is gifted with a sense of humor for a reason. Okay. Yogananda used to say, a good sense of humor goes a long ways in making life a lot better. So, realize the things that you're saying, you just need to go try these things. Just go have a physical experience. You know, just experience it with your whole being, and then your body can register, is this even me? And maybe when you go to actually have the physical experience, meaning you actually go do it. Oh, I really think, oh, look at that, I'm always thinking about skydiving. Well, just go do it. Well, you might get to the plane, and you might look down and go, all right, I'm done skydiving, take me home. You still had a physical experience of it. That's all the physical experience you needed. So what I'm saying is, watch what you're saying. Watch what's coming in your mouth. Go try those things. No, they're not meant to work. Are they a waste of your time? No. Because they help you find out what you really are. Because so much of the consciousness spoken is just garbage. It's not coming from the true place of us. And there's only one way to find out. For our body to encounter it and say, actually, that's not who I am. And it can be in all kinds of things. All the crazy things that come out of your mouth and the crazy things dwell in your mind that are eventually going to pop out of your mouth. At some point when you're talking to some person who you think it can pop out to without you getting slapped. Okay? All right. The other interesting thing about the consciousness spoken is lots of times when we're struggling, and so a person with a good Mercury is more willing to try the things that come out of your mouth. I knew a guy with a great Mercury. He'd say, oh, I live in this town because I can try anything here. And it's not too big of a city like LA. He goes, but everything's here. I know that if I get into my mind that I need to experience this, I can do it without leaving my city, you know? And the rate this person learned astrology at, wow, did they have a great Mercury. Wow, did they do good readings really fast. I mean, they had a wonderful, wonderful Mercury. And part of that was, I'm willing to try anything that my mind entertains and to find out what it means. Yes, this person was a sex slave at one point of his life to some famous S&M babe. Okay. But wow, he decided that wasn't really him. And he left and he became a fantastic astrologer. Okay, really capable, skilled, intelligent person. So it's a funny thing that the mind wants to try, you know. But if we don't try it, we don't find out if it's really us or not. And if we don't find out if it's really us or not, we're stuck. It's better to try and fail and find out that's not us. And like I said, we don't always have to. The try, you don't know, like, okay, he was a sex slave for a couple of years. And, you know, and he said, okay, I'm done with that, it's not really me. But you might just show up, and the minute the girl walks out with the whip, you're like, okay, that's not me, and you leave. Okay? It might just be that. You might get to the door and not be able to knock. Madame, I'm here, you know? It might end there, but it'll end when your body goes, actually, this is not me. Because the truth is not in our pea brain. The truth is in our being, and our being pervades our entire body. Okay? And that's the truth we want to get in touch with. And Mercury does it in the most humorous ways. Okay? So watch what you're saying. One of the great things about Mercury is that it rules the, what's called twag, which means the coverings of your body. Okay? It's what you cover yourself in. Now, the moon is your manas. It's where your individual self lives, your jiva, the individual self within you lives in your moon, your manas. Okay? So the moon is where the ego is, the self. The self you're working with is all about the moon. And it has a covering. And our manas is our entire consciousness, everything we're experiencing, perceiving, and within and without of ourselves. But then the consciousness spoken is Mercury. Okay? Our coverings and the conscious spoken are very superficial compared to what's going on inside. Okay? So the idea of this is that you can change what you look like. You can actually change your personality. Okay? Part of being ourselves is we can change our personality. We can mix it up. We get to be actors on this stage. Okay? We can go be with different kinds of people and have a different personality. Okay? And we can experience ourselves as different personalities. All right? We can change our coverings. All right? Now, of course, literally, we're not going to change our skin. But if we broaden that to the idea that we're always covered in clothing, think how much we can change our personality just by changing clothes, you know? Like on Halloween, someone might dress up as a gangster. And you're like, dude, that cuts it for you somehow. Wow, you know? It's fun to see what the clothing can do to how a person's image is. And what that is, it's simply manifesting a different part of ourselves. See, the part of us that we need to just try manifesting right now is the consciousness spoken. We just want to trust and try that part. And we also can do that by changing our coverings. And it's funny to see, one of our coverings is our hair. Mercury rules everything that covers your body. And of course, our hair is the changeable one, right? It's always fun to me to watch people as they change their hair style, their hair color. Of course, girls are a lot more fun to watch because they do it a lot more often, but it's always fun to see people's relationship to their hair and see how they're trying to change things up, changing their coverings. And that's the job of Mercury. I'm going to try to see what kind of results I get when I put this personality on? And it can simply be, I'm going to see what kind of results I get by being a nicer, sweeter person. I'm going to see what kind of results I'm going to get by just being a tougher person. And then finding out, wow, that really worked. We're being tough really, really works. Everyone just lined up and everything's working better. Now I'm a little tougher. So we get to try operating in different ways. A healthy Mercury is in the habit of trying that. It has a goal. It wants to get somewhere. We do. And when it gets to Mercury, it's like, okay, I'm going to try this. Oh, that didn't work. Okay, how about I try this? Oh, that didn't work. Let me try this. That worked. Cool. Okay? It's the same as Sherlock finding the bad guy. That's not that guy. It's not that guy. That guy didn't work. Oh, this guy works. So if we can change our personalities, okay, if we can go from being tough to being sweet, from being strong to being vulnerable, this gives us so many means to move down the road. So Mercury, the whole idea with Mercury is it's an extension of our adaptability. The moon is, okay, I have to adapt. Well, adapting means you just try something and see what works best. It's really an extension of the moon. The moon's all about, I have to adapt, be receptive and open to the best option, and work with that best option. And Mercury's like, yep, that makes sense. And I'm here to find out what that best option is by trying this, that, and that. I'll try this person, this person, this person, this job, and this job, this road, and this road, this personality, and this personality. And none of those are fake things. They're just us trying to discover ourselves, what we can do, what we are capable of, what bringing out different parts of ourselves allows to work. We all have a tough part. You can't say to anyone, tough is not you. We all have a tough part. You can't say to anyone, vulnerable is not you. We all have a vulnerable part. So Mercury is like, yeah, let me use these different parts of me, these different things in my mind, in my being, my manas, in my dad, the moon, and see how I work with that and how my life works for that. And it's like, wow, that part worked. So in our lives, we don't just choose roads and options. We literally get a choice of, oh, I get to be this way. You know, we think of, we have choices all the time, and Mercury is the one that tries our choices. But we want to remember, we also have the choices of how we can try to be. Wow, that's an important choice. And this whole course is really, the people with good Mercuries are going to do best, because they're just going to try to make the choice of trying to be something different. Okay, they're going to try to make decisions in a different way. They're just going to try something new. And the better your Mercury, the easier it is for you to try something new. It's hard to try things new when Mercury is worse and worse and worse. So, Mercury so much gives us the ability to grow. How I say is, Jupiter is the wisdom and the goodness you're born with. Mercury is what you can learn, though. You know? So if you're born an idiot, but you can learn, you can go a lot further sometimes than a genius who can't learn, okay? So Mercury is this planet that is in the learning stage. It's the prince learning to become a man, okay? And by man, I mean capable, competent, and able after discovering himself, you know? Education is about finding out what we're good at, not about memorizing things, okay? And that's what Mercury is doing. Okay, the taste of Mercury is umami. Now, umami is the taste of gluten. It's what MSG makes our taste buds act. MSG activates that taste bud. Meat, cooked tomatoes, cooked mushroom, cheese, all these foods that create a good base and enhance other flavors are this umami flavor. Okay, and the idea of this umami is that things can be enhanced. Okay, through Mercury. So Mercury is the one that realizes a good, healthy Mercury, a good habit Mercury is, well, now that I'm here, I can make this better. I can enhance this. This is good, but let me add a little pinch of this and a little pinch of that and make it better. And one of the ways it does that is by adopting the mood and the personality that does enhance things. Okay, so people who are in the habit of using their Mercury in a good way are able to make things better. They're able to enhance something, give something a little more power, okay, whatever it is, a little more emphasis. This is why Mercury also makes a good speaker, because the difference between a good and bad speaker is the emphases that get placed into different places. Some people have a better ability to speak, which means they know how to emphasize certain things, that it makes it easier for people to remember. It enhances people's ability to learn, okay? There's a whole, studies have been done on what those things are. I have no idea what they are, and I have no idea what if I'm doing them or not. I hope I am, if not, too bad. Okay. Too busy studying astrology to study those things. But a good Mercury is the enhancer. It's like, this is what's here. Let's try to make it better, okay? We can make it better. There's always a way to make every situation better. And the good Mercury is in the habit of finding that way. A bad Mercury is in the habit of doing one or two things. Not making a situation better. Oh, that's what it is. I'm leaving. Or, that's what it is, and I'm going to tell myself it's really perfect. It's like, let's just show a blind eye to all the trash under the rug and live in that house. Okay, that's what a bad Mercury is in the habit of doing. Putting things under the rug. Good Mercury is like, I'm on it. I'm paying attention. I want to talk about it. I want to see how we can enhance this moment, make this situation better. Okay, they're good at that. And the bodily power of Mercury is sound. Okay, well, it's sound because sound is most present in humans in our vocal cords, allowing us to speak. Okay, so it's the power to make sound, to make noise. All right. Well, how that? So, are you in the habit of making noise or not? Are you in the habit of making good noise or not? That's really what it comes down to. Do you make noise? Do you attract attention in a way that allows for things to be enhanced and move forward, and for everyone to learn something about themselves, to learn what their needs really are, to learn what they're confused about? Or are you in the habit of making noise that does the opposite, or not making any noise at all? Okay, because it's by making noise, getting people's attention about something, that we do that. I mean, when you really think about it, it's noise, sound, that gets people's attention. See, I only can see what's in front of me. So if someone's in front of me, they can jump up and down, and not jump up and down, they can wave their hand, which doesn't make any noise, and I'll see it, right? But if I was surrounded by people, most people could not get my attention that way. If it was dark out, nobody could get my attention that way. I don't have the nose to smell somebody's hand waving, and I don't even know if a dog can smell someone's hand waving, actually. Although he might smell the emotion of a waving hand, you know. But you see, with humans, our attention is gotten by sound more than anything else. So, are we in the habit of making sounds that help us get the attention we need for our life to work out better? Or do we make sounds that are just pathetic whimperings that get us nowhere and nothing? Okay? And the sound you have to make to get what you need, what's right for you, can just be so different in different situations. It could be the sound of vulnerability. It could be the sound of strength, you know? And we have to do the sound that gets us, that works, and we have to try what it is. So first we act all tough and hurt. That doesn't work. All right, well, I'm gonna play the vulnerable sound. Oh, now the person is recognizing what my need is. An unhealthy Mercury doesn't make the right sounds. It makes no sounds or sounds that make everything not work, even things that they need to work, even things that would be right for them to work. It always amazes me when I see someone with a really great Mercury and just how they're able to do all these things to make things have the best chance of working. It's really what Mercury is all about. Yes, I'm going to try this. Yes, most things don't work. But I'm here to do the things that give this the best chance of working. And if they don't work after that, these things are definitely not the right things for me. And if it does work after that, if I just keep finding it working, if every time I try to enhance something, try to make something work better, try something in a better way, and if every time it works, wow, then this is what's right in my life. Because see, the right life for you is the life that works, that's free from frustrations, okay? And that's free from being drained and exhausted by burdens and things that just don't work except to push you deeper into the mud, okay? We want a life that works. And yes, our inner voice knows the life that works, but we're too confused to hear that inner voice. So Mercury is here to say, wow, I'm trying this. I'm in the habit of trying and I'm seeing it work. I'm seeing it work, okay? And so it must be right for me, because if it is working, it's right for you. Even if you didn't hear your inner voice, if it's working, it's right, okay? And along with that, yes, I'm trying this and it's not working. All right, I'm just going to be Vishnu about it. You know, this job's not working. There's some other guy who wants this job. I'll just quit. This person's not working. You know, this person would work with somebody else. I'm just going to quit. You know, this diet's not working. It worked for my friend, but it's not working for me. It doesn't have to work. Nothing works for everybody. A lot of things only going to work for one person. Let that person have it. You know, find out what works for you. And you have that attitude about it. And then your wounds don't get hurt. You don't want to kill yourself. That's what's great about being a Vishnu devotee, is realizing that God is doing God. And whatever we have God. You know, all right, I'm not doing her, I'm not doing him, but I'm going to do a hike. I'm doing God still. I'm going to do that there mountain. I'm going to climb that mountain, I'm not going to climb her. Okay, you're still climbing God. Use that part of your Mercury. Realize that there's always an experience of God in your life, in what you're doing. And by God, I mean something that can be meaningful and fulfilling to you, as that job was, as that person was, that turned out to maybe just not work. And so Vishnu helps Mercury do this role of trying and failing in a way that's not painfully destructive, you know, where we're not all hanging off bridges, you know, by our necks. And then he gets a sense of humor too. You know, a sense of humor goes a long way towards accepting defeat, okay? All right. Now, the next planet after Mercury, we're going to slip into the Libra Taurus signs. Okay, we're going to slip into Venus. Because once you find things working, you find out that they're worth having. Because it's what's worth having, it's what's working that's worth having, right? Having a car that works is worth having, right? Having a car that does not work, oh, is that frustrating? And you'd just be better off without it. Even you just give it away and lost the $10,000 you bought it for, you know? Okay, what works is what you're going to become valuable to you, what's going to become important to you. And Venus represents everything that is worth having in your life, that's worth you investing in, to continue to invest in. And that's the planet we'll talk about next. I'm going to make sure I didn't forget anything here. Okay, I just want to summarize with, so basically a good habit, Mercury, is the extension of the moon's ability to adapt. He tries, he adapts, he shifts and he moves. He tries this, then he tries this. He smiles and he screams. He cusses and then he's vulnerable. He tries different strategies. He tries different suspects. I suspect being a little tougher with this person will make everything work. And you try it. Did it work or not? No, it didn't work. I suspect I should probably apologize right now. So you apologize and it worked. Wow. That's Mercury. It's a fun thing to see Mercury. It's recognizing that we have so many options to try. Try it with the things in your life. We have so many options to live. Try the ones that are coming out of your mouth. You know, just try those things and see if those are even experiences you really do care about. Get out of what's in your mind into a real experience to find out if that thing's really you. Or it's just something that got stuck in your mind because of some pathology or something hammered into your head or just through some belief you picked up somewhere. It's funny the things we believe. I remember for years and years and years, I just wanted to see Raquel Welch. Boy, did I want to see a movie with Raquel Welch. Why? Because when I was a five-year-old kid, it was 1975, and Raquel Welch was really cool, and my mom, who I really, really respect, and I think is a wonderful woman, said, Raquel Welch is just so beautiful. She is an amazing figure. And so I always wanted to see Raquel Welch in a movie, and I think I finally did a few years ago, you know? And yeah, she had a great body, but you know, she really wasn't my kind of girl, you know? And so I had an experience of Raquel Welch. This thing got stuck in my mind. And I realized, you know, I'd rather have a petite brunette, you know, than a Raquel Welch, okay? So how do these things get stuck in our mind? And I would say that, oh yeah, Raquel Welch, she's beautiful. You know, I'd make Raquel Welch jokes. You know, when it came to when I was making a beautiful woman joke, Raquel Welch was good chance she was going to be part of the joke, you know. And yet I'd never seen a movie with her, you know. But this, my mom said it, and boy, did it impact me. Raquel Welch is a goddess, you know. And she's a beautiful, wonderful woman. She's definitely a fine woman, but she's not my goddess, okay? All right. So, go try those things that come out of your mouth, and you can have so much peace. It's just one more thing that's not part of you anymore. Raquel Welch is not part of my lust in this world anymore, okay? All right. And realize there's no failure in trying. There is no failure in trying. That's a healthy Mercury. And realize you have many, many options. We're in a buffet of everything. There's a buffet of places to live. There's a buffet of babes. There's a buffet of men out there. There's even a buffet of food. And you can try every one of them to see which one works for you. Okay? And any of those things not working is acceptable. If you eat shrimp and it gives you indigestion, no big deal. Don't eat it again. If you go on a date with Raquel Welch and you don't have anything to talk about, no big deal. Just don't go on a date with her again. Okay? That's the healthy Mercury. Just don't repeat things that don't work. That's all Mercury wants. Are you in the habit of repeating things that don't work? You know, we say, to be in astrology, mental illness is indicated by afflicted moon and Mercury. They both have to be bombed. If you've got a trash moon, you've got a great Mercury, you're not going to go into the institute, okay? Or vice versa. If you've got a trash Mercury and a good moon, you're not going to end up in the institute. But if both are in bad shape, you're in trouble. Why? Because part of insanity is doing the same thing over and over again and expecting the same a different result. Okay, that's one definition of insanity. And that's what a bad Mercury makes us do. I'm going to try this thing again. No, a good Mercury is in the habit. I tried that. I know it's not going to work. I tried that fruit on the deserted island I was stuck on, and I had nausea and fever for 3 days. I am never going to eat that again. You know? But wow, in other parts of our life, we do that. In fact, even with food, we're such idiots. You know? I tried feeding my baby pizza when they were 6 months old, and they pooped, they screamed, they woke me up that night. Now they feel better, and we're having pizza tonight. And you feed them pizza again. You wonder why the little bastard keeps you up all night, because you fed him pizza, and his stomach's screaming at him, because humans aren't designed to eat pizza. Okay, so a healthy Mercury's in the habit of trying something without any concerns of failure. I'm just trying it to discover. And if it doesn't work, no big deal. And the only big deal about it not working is, I'm not going to keep trying that unless I adopt another personality. I'm not going to keep trying to talk to that person as a strong, cool person. But maybe I'll go talk to that person as a vulnerable person. Oh, that didn't work either. Okay. I'm going to try to talk to that person. I'm not going to talk. I'm just going to put my sexiest top on and just walk by him. That didn't work. All right, what else can I try? Until you run out of ways, and then you realize it really, really doesn't work. So I'm not saying don't try the same thing twice. Don't try the same thing the same way twice. So on that deserted island where you're starving, you need to eat food, you need to adapt to that environment, and you try the berries, and the berries make you sick. I'm going to try the berries again. But this time, I'm going to cook the berries. Because in cooking the berries, the toxin, which is always a protein, that protein will change, and many things that are toxic, when you cook them, you can eat them. So I would cook them and then eat them and see if I got sick. And if I got sick, I would distill them, you know, and make booze out of them and see if I can drink the booze and these feel good while I'm alone on that island and not get sick other than a hangover. So you try it a different way. That's also a healthy part of Mercury, is adopting our personality, adopting the consciousness spoken, the words we use to approach someone. You know, it's like those, I always make the joke when I'm counseling people, you know, a man on how to meet women, you know. You see these romantic movies, and verily there's the babe and there's the nerdy guy, right? And the nerdy guy tries to get a date, and he tries to get a date. And finally the girl just laughs and says, okay, I'll go out with you, you know? So if we just keep trying, and we try it in different ways, eventually things might work. And then they can turn into a beautiful romance. But if we tried everything in the book, we tried this, this, and that, and it's still, this way didn't work, this didn't work, that means the thing doesn't work, okay? But if you try this and it doesn't work, try another tactic. Find the tactic that works. Because nothing works in just one dimension. We have Mercury's, we have this ability to adapt, to choose different words, to choose different moods, to put on different personas, not as fake parts of ourselves, but as revealing different aspects of ourselves. And we need to always use the aspect that works. And the reality is, your inner voice knows how you need to approach this for it to work, if it's a working thing. So your inner voice will say yes to this thing. And it's also saying, you need to be this way. Okay? But are we going to hear it? Because we'll have the mood. I'm going to go up to that girl. I'm going to go to that interview and act like, you know, you're making these decisions of how you're going to be when you approach things. And your inner voice will say, well, maybe you shouldn't be that way. Or, yeah, that's the way to be. And so it's even guiding us in that. But it's so hard to hear that inner voice again. So you just try. You can just keep trying, you know. And, yeah, by the time you show up to that girl's office for the fourth time with, you know, a different gift, you're starting to look like a fool. But maybe that what that girl is waiting for is a fool of a guy. And then that fourth time you show up with a different gift, that's when the adoration strikes her. Because you're the fool of a man she's been waiting for. You never know what's going to work. Try something different. That's what a good Mercury is in the habit of. We have options of how we do something, and we have options with what we do something with. And we need to find the working ones, and only through Mercury will we. That's why the people who have good Mercuries, those are my funnest people to watch. Where they started, where they are, and where they end up. Because them more than other have this kind of thing. They just have this. You know, you can, whether you start here or whether you start here, it ain't good enough. You want to go this way, you know? And a good Mercury helps a lot in that, because you don't get anywhere when you don't try. That's the worst habit of Mercury. I'm in the habit of not trying things that are new. I'm in the habit of not trying different things. I'm in the habit of not trying. It's essentially saying I'm in the habit of not living. Okay? And I'm in the habit of not trying until I know it's going to work. All right, we're having our first date. So, do you think you're going to be married in 2 years? You know, I don't know. Well, then I'm not interested. It's like, wow, okay, bye, babe. You know, obviously the wrong girl. But people are like that until they know. All right, you're willing to be married in 2 years. The astrologer said the compatibility is okay. The astrologer predicted I would meet my true love and I would get married in 2 years. And he would have this much money. Excuse me, how much money do you make? I mean, until everything is perfectly defined forever, they don't want to try something. All or nothing. Okay, and that means nothing every time. A good Mercury doesn't need to know all those details. It doesn't have to have all the eggs lined up. It just has to know, I could try this. and I can, and if I can live through it not working, I'll be okay with it not working. I'm okay if I try and I walk out of the office with those flowers that I want to throw in the trash now, and some guy walks in there without flowers and gets a date with her. I'm okay with that, because that means he's right for her, and there's a girl out there that's right for me. I'm okay if showing up to that job interview and not getting the job, because the job belongs to someone who will do it better than me, and I have a job waiting for me, and I'm just going to keep trying and looking and investigating until I find it, whatever it is. I need to find out, like money. Oh, I'm always talking about the relationships because I get so many woman clients. They're always talking about love. And I have Ra in the seventh house too. But wow, men, do they come to me about money. Oh, how am I going to make money? I don't know, dude. Don't waste my time. Just try to make money. Okay, try to do something to make money. And you will certainly find out how to make money, you know. We become kings by being princess. We become queens by being princesses. Not by laying around for someone to come and kiss our beautiful lips awake. We do those things by trying. Are you in the habit of trying in a healthy way, or are you in the habit of not trying in an unhealthy way, or, you know, trying? Okay? That's the foundation of Mercury. And the willingness, I'm in the good habit of accepting failure. That's a good habit, Mercury. I accept failure habitually good, except when it comes to chess. And, or I don't accept failure. I condemn myself. I beat myself up. I hate myself. I want to kill myself when I have failure. Okay? Which is the habit you're in when you confront failure. That's Mercury. Okay? So I hope that helps everyone understand the Mercury. Again, we'll talk about the details of the actual experiences of different types of, you know, bad habit Mercuries, because they all function differently. But that'll give you a good idea of, are you using your Mercury habitually good or not? Okay, thank you.